Hello friends, in this video I'll be helping with the difference between IPv4 and IPv6 in a very easy way and with the help of very simple points. So do watch the whole video. So let's start. So here I've made two columns, IPv4 and IPv6. So if we talk about the IPv4, the source and the destination address are of 32 bits. That is basically the 4 bytes in length. If we talk about IPv6, source and destination address are of 128 bits, that is 16 bytes in length. So if we compare IPv6 and IPv4 in terms of source and destination address, then IPv6 is much greater as compared to IPv4. If we talk about IPv4, IPv6 support is optimal, or you can say it is almost negligible. But if we talk about the IPv6 support is required. What is IPsec support? It is basically the IP security, or you can say cryptographic support. So in IPv4, the security is not not properly defined. But if we talk about the IPv6, the security is a very large concern, because if we talk about IPv4, when IPv4 was introduced a decade before, that time security was not of very much concern. That time it was in developing stage, but now IPv6 came and you can see that the security is very important. If we say about IPv4, the fragmentation is done by both router as well as sending host. So this was the traditionally this was done, but you can see that fragmentation done at both router as well as sending host. So what it will use more computation, and also it will cause delay. But if we talk about the IPv6, it is basically the advanced version. Fragmentation is done by not done by the routers, it is only done by the sending host. Thus you can say delays, less delays cost and less computation is used, does making the services more faster. If we talk about the IPv4, the header includes a checksum. But if we talk about IPv6, the header does not have any checksum. It may have an optional one, but not in the main header part. Header includes option. If we talk about IPv4, so the main header part of IPv4 has options. So it is very tough when IPv4 interchanges platform different kinds. When you can say IP address at one platform communicates with IP address and another platform, then it is very difficult to categorize the necessary things or necessary part of header. So IPv6 is improved in this. All optional data is moved to the IPv6 extension header, and the IPv6 header is the necessary part. That means it should have the IPv6 header part, then only it will be considered, and you can keep the optional data in IPv6 extension header. If we talk about IPv4, it uses decimal numbers. So the time at which it was introduced, that time decimal number were okay, but nowadays the computers are in very large numbers, or again the systems are in very large numbers from before, so it uses hexadecimal numbers. If we talk about the simple difference, if we talk about IPv4, it is separated by a dot, like you can see 192.168.100.1. But if we talk about the IPv6, it is separated by a colon, like FC00:00:10001000 will be there here also, and then :0100:0FCT. So this was just the example to show you that how you can differentiate between IPv4 and IPv6. So it has 5 classes, the class A, class B, class C, class D and class E. So if you want to know about it, you can watch my video on different classes of IP address. But if we talk about the IPv6, there is no such concept. Basically there are no such classes. Why so? Because why to categorize IP address in different classes, like 255 are there, then why to categorize into different classes? It will make the basically it will make it more complex, because every time you have to keep a IP address in a class, and then use it accordingly. But it was improved in IPv6. There is no such class, so whenever IP address is free, it is allotted. It doesn't matter whether it is allotted for research and development, whether it is then for multicast, it will perform, any IP address will perform the same work, right? So why to categorize them into different classes? So this is the concept. So this was all about IPv4 and IPv6. So if you like the video, do hit the like button, do consider subscribing, and thanks for watching.